All right, guys, this is a quick everyday carry to work bag update. And so far, the Gunnison Marmot or Marmot bag has been holding up extremely well. To be honest with you, about the only problem that I've had with it is weight. As you saw, there's quite a lot of things going on there, but this thing has just held up like a champ. Usually I used to buy the what were they? I think it was the outdoor products things from Walmart, and those things would start to tear up. They would hold up for a little while, but then they would start to tear up. But this thing has basically seen, I would say, essentially no degradation. No deterioration. As you can see, the stitching. I mean, I carry this thing to work every day without fail. The stitching has remained. There's no fraying. The zippers still work. There's been no delamination on the inside. You see, the stitching is fine. And this thing is usually pretty much packed to the gills. All right. So, this is about the only thing here. Just a couple loose threads here, which can be easily mended, and as we know, a stitch in time saves nine, so I'll get on that. But otherwise, this thing has held up extraordinarily. Now, I'm not a bag abuser, but it gets thrown into my work vehicle. Get slammed around a little bit, falling onto the floor, sliding off the front seat if I have it sitting on the front seat. But by and large, man, this thing has been great. It was well worth the extra money compared to the outdoor product stuff that I had been buying. And the only thing I wish it had was maybe some daisy chain webbing on this part. That way I can attach some things to the outside a little easier. But I do use these straps here. Just loop something through there and then close it that way. But this thing has held up like a champ. And what I'll do is just go over some of these things in detail. Just by pointing out what they are. Not in this video, unfortunately, but I will perhaps add maybe a PDF or something that pretty much showcases everything that's in here. This is, I guess, a combination get home bag and mobile office at the same time. I have a lot of paperwork things in there. I have a lot of office type material in there, different tools, electronics, cables and batteries and chargers and such in there. Just some home toiletries there, pens, pencils, you name it. Even some preparation H toiletables, which of course you shouldn't flush. But just wrap it up and put it in a waste can. And of course, you have your gear here, your what would you call that? That would be your shelter type materials there. And even one of these, living in the city and driving in some of the more sketchy parts of town with my job. This certainly would come in handy, perhaps. Haven't used it yet. Thankfully, hopefully I'll never have to use it. But yeah, I'll just give an overview of everything in a PDF, take some pictures and just show everything that I carry to work every day. And even have one of these here. Breath of Life emergency escape mask. You might be able to see something online about this. Basically, it's something similar to like a Mylar bag that you put over your head with a filter membrane on there. And it's, you just rip it open, hold it in place with two rubber bands around your neck. Hopefully, it doesn't choke you to death. But, it's supposed to work. All right. So, as I said, I just wanted to give a quick everyday carry to work bag update. And I'll go over everything perhaps in a PDF, because as you can see, there's a lot of stuff here. And I think my last video for this was probably two parts. I'm sure you guys don't want to hear me talking for all that length of time, but you still might be interested in what I carry every day. So I'll see if I can get that done for you. All right. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, just let me know. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.